welcome to FX Bootcamp. Today is Wednesday, July 18th, 2007. My name is Kurt Worley, and this is your New York session video briefing. It's a video review of what we did in the live classes today at fxbootcamp.com. What you see here are the USD CAD 5-minute chart on the left, 15-minute chart here in the middle, and the 1-hour chart on the right showing both pivot points and Fibonacci extensions of yesterday's range. This is the setup we use today for news. We started today's New York session a little early, just as news from Canada hit the market. In this case, it was the Canadian Consumer Price Index, or CPI, news. Now, our plan for trading news is this. We let the news come out, wait for the first 5-minute candle to close, use it to identify support or resistance, then trade it technically when volatility is more tolerable. Now, here are the numbers from Trade the News as they came out at exactly 7 a.m. Eastern Time, New York time. And we've got core CPI, again, core CPI for June, which saw 0.0% growth for the prior month, from the prior month. That was less than the expected 0.1% growth. Now, that might be bearish for the Canadian dollar, or in other words, bullish for the USD CAD. And sure enough, so I'll show you the first 5-minute candle, we get a big green candle. Now, what's interesting about the close of this candle is that we've got the M4 daily pivot point at 1.0457 today, and the weekly M2 pivot point at 458. So I'm very comfortable withdrawing this resistance line based on the first 5-minute candle close at 459. So now your trade plan is to enter on a break of that level, 459, or wait for a retracement to a dynamic level support such as the upper Bollinger Band or the 5 EMA and the 5-minute chart here. Now, let me be honest with you. A retracement is certainly possible and could provide a very good entry. But if the resistance here is broken, then you might get left behind. And that's the chance you always take. Ultimately, you've got to make a decision up front as to what you're going to do, then execute your trade plan when price does what you anticipate it might do, or do nothing if price doesn't do what you expect. So let's see what happens. And there's the break. So you're in at 460 if that was your trade plan. Now, for a profit target for you guys who entered there, let's check out the hourly chart here on the right. Now, we are above the M4 pivot point now and also above the 55 EMA on the 1-hour chart. I see the 200 EMA up here on the 1-hour chart at about 486, which nests about 20 pips based on our entry at 460. So let's go with that as a conservative target. Aggressive target would be likely the 500 psychological level, just about 14 pips above that. So conservative target, 486, based on the 200 EMA and the 1-hour chart. Aggressive target, 500 psychological level. Let's look at next candles here. Here's the 5-minute candle and the first 15-minute candle as well. Notice we're still riding the Bollinger Band here on the 5-minute chart. Let me give you a couple more candles. Seeing a series of lower highs here on the 5-minute chart. Not a problem. That's a standard continuation pattern. And the 5 EMA here in the 5-minute chart is caught up with price, so that might help our cause. Now, if you enter the trade based on the break of 459, this next candle here, this little green candle here, might have freaked you out a bit because it retraced all the way back to our resistance line at 459. Now, that didn't concern me because I'm expecting a roll reversal here. Now, what that means is what used to be resistance, in this case, this 459 line, or more specifically, M4 at 457 today, becomes support. Again, roll reversal, resistance becomes support. Also, look at where the 5 EMA is now on the 15-minute chart on the right here. The 5 EMA is starting to approach our entry level at 460. So that, it's about to catch up with price and potentially provide some dynamic support. So now you've got two good reasons why this 459-ish area was a great second chance entry for those of you who are looking to enter on some kind of retracement. Also, if you were already in before, it was a good reason to hang with it and give it a chance to go further. Let's see what some more candles bring us here. A couple more green candles, new higher high, that's all good. Show you the next 15-minute candle. That's all good too, right? There was your there was a second chance entry for those of you who are looking for a retracement to the 5 EMA. You got that. Also, it was a retest of former resistance, now support. So we've made a higher high. We're up about a dozen pips. And the 5 EMA is around 460-ish here. Actually, next 15-minute candle, look moving forward. 5 EMA is now at 465-ish. So what you might have done is this. You're up about a dozen pips. You might choose to move your stop to break even and see if this can run, or simply move your stop to about a few pips below the 5 EMA here, or at least below that swing low at 460. So ultimately, we're looking for new higher highs now. I'll ride the 5 scenario. How far can this thing run? Let's find out. Ah, unfortunately we got this, a bearish engulfing candle that would have stopped you out of break even, or maybe worst case, the loss of just a handful of pips. That's a bummer, but you know what, that can happen. Let's look back in time to why this area here around 475-ish might have been important. I'm going to switch to a 4-hour chart to give you a look at that. Here's the 4-hour chart, and here's what I notice. You've got 475-ish area, important right in here, right in there, certainly there, even a little bit of stuff in here going on at 475. And that was our high, in fact, in that area for today. So that was likely the reason why the price got held up at that level. Again, it's mostly visual, former visual support, now visual resistance on from a longer term time frame there. Again, could have gone farther, just wasn't in the cards for the day. So there you have it, a news trade just before the New York Open that had potential but just didn't pan out. Hey, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Today is Wednesday, July 18th, 2007, and this has been your New York Session Video Briefing by FX Bootcamp.